The graph of a function f is shown below. If both the limit of f of x as x approaches k and f of k exist, and f is not continuous at k, then what is the value of k? So we need to find a k where f is not continuous at k, but f of k is defined, and the limit as x approaches k of f of x is also defined. So the easiest ones to spot out just with our eyes might just be to see where f is not continuous, where f is not continuous. So you see here, when x is equal to -2, when x is equal to -2, the function is not continuous. It jumps from up here, it's approaching, it looks like it's approaching 3, and then it jumps down to -3. So this is one of our candidates. This is one of our candidates for k. The other discontinuity happens when x is equal to 3. Once again, we jump down from, it looks like 4.5 all the way to -4. So that's another candidate. That's a point where f is not continuous. And then we have, when x is equal to 8, we have this, as we approach this, it looks like we're getting to 1, but then we jump right at x equals 8, and then we continue from 1 again. So this is our other candidate. So these are the three candidates where the function is not continuous. Now let's think about which of these points, which of these x values does f of k exist? So if one of these is k, does f of k exist? Well, f of -2 exists, f of 3 exists right over here. That's f of 3, this is f of -2, and f of 8 all exist. So all of these potential k's meet this constraint, f of k exists, and f is not continuous at k. So that's true for x equals 8, 3, or -2. Now let's look at this first constraint. The limit of f of x as x approaches k needs to exist. Well, if we tried to look at x equals 2, the limit of f of x as x approaches -2, not 2, as x approaches -2 here, the limit from the left, the limit from values lower than -2, it looks like our function is approaching something a little higher, looks like it's a little higher than 3. And the limit from the right, it looks like our function is approaching -3. So this one, the limit does not exist. You get a different limit from the left and from the right. Same thing for x equals +3. The limit from the left seems like it's approaching 4.5, while the limit from the right looks like it's approaching -4. So this is also not a candidate. So we only have one left, so for this one, the limit should exist. And we see the limit as f of x as x approaches 8 from the negative direction, it looks like f of x is approaching 1. And it looks like as we approach 8 from the positive direction, the limit of f of x as x approaches 8 from the positive direction, it's also equal to 1. So your left and your right-sided limits approach the same value. So the limit of f of x as x approaches 8 is equal to 1. This limit exists. Now the reason why the function isn't continuous there is that the limit of f of x as x approaches 8, which is equal to 1, it does not equal the value of f of 8. F of 8, we're seeing, is equal to 7. So that's why it meets the last constraint. The function is not continuous there. The function exists. It's defined. F of 8 is equal to 7. And the limit exists. But the limit of f of x as x approaches k is not the same thing, or is not the same as the value of the function evaluated at that point. And so x equals 8 meets all of our constraints. So we could say k is equal to 8.